It's coming for us, Captain. It has eyes as big as basketballs. It can see everywhere, even in the pitch black water. It has a beak like Mom's parakeets, but 1,000 times bigger that can cut you right in half. And 8 legs that can rip a blue whale's head off, and tentacles that feed it to its beak. If it gets me, I'm toast. If it gets you, you're a bacon sandwich. Watch out, Captain! The Leviathan has the ship!
Inside the reason the sun broke down, where the river runs into town. A shadow passes the moon at night, and the caves are lonely without their light. Horsemen riding into the dawn, look out your window and sing them a song. Where the gates are open, the torches flare, the pyres burn and the scrolls appear. The ladies dress and the wagons roll, the gold arrives and the sun explodes. I hid myself in a swamp of mud where the water drips and the water flows. You left me twice, the train rides. The sun comes up and the river's dry. The planets move and the stars appear. Where the moon leaves tracks for the people's tears. The dark is dark and the light is me. Oh, Howard Hughes, he told me to stay. Well, I left my home and the sweet gum tree, where the butterflies and the bumblebees. I sleep on a log and the sleep is good, and in the distance I hear the hoods, where the end is now and the now is over. The axe stands by and the fires run cold. Got the boxcar blues as the train moves on. Well, the hobo with me sings a song.
Jonathan, man, I told you to check the traps, local swimming.
We went fishing.
You can't fish underwater, and who is we?
Me and Wee-Wee.
Don't molest that pig, and go get ready for school, please.
No, take your medicine.
Mm-mm, all of it.
Come on.
Chew it up. I want to see it gone.
Hello.
You have a collect call from caller. Say your name.
David.
Do you accept?
Yes.
Hey, Dad. Still there?
Oh,
She's not.
Would you like me to give her a message?
No, never mind. I wrote her a letter.
When are you gonna come home and take care of your business, son?
Okay, well, gotta go. I'll try it later then.
Listen to me, if you...
So what do you want to study in school today?
Sea monsters.
Sea monsters are not a subject. Let's do math instead.
Okay. I'm 9 years old and you're 27.
Yes, sir.
That means you were 18 when you had me.
Yeah, well, let's not do math today either. Why don't we study science? We can do dinosaurs.
How about prehistoric sea creatures?
Okay, fine. As long as they're real. Which one's this?
Predator X, which is a Pliocene with 12-inch teeth.
So is that the baddest creature in the ocean?
Some people say this one's the baddest, a megalodon. But pliosaurs are cooler than sharks, mm-hmm. And the megalodon only had 8-inch teeth.
Do you think that it was really an asteroid that killed him, like that book says?
I guess so.
Well, you know what? I think that's dumb. I don't think an asteroid could destroy everything that's on the whole planet. I don't even think a nuclear bomb could do that. We dropped a couple of those on Japan in World War II, and it didn't do nothing. I still got a radio from the 90s that was made in Japan.
But they say that asteroid was a million times
stronger. Hey, on break.
What's up, Curtis?
Got it in. What's up, buddy?
Hey, Curtis.
Hi, Joe.
So we got a question for you.
Okay.
What do you think killed the dinosaurs?
Well, there was a polar shift, and Earth's magnets got reversed. And it went from being 80 degrees to like 500 degrees in the shade, and they all melted, became tar. That's where oil comes from. Fossil fuels. Now we fight wars over dead dinosaurs and drugs.
Yeah, you're probably right about that.
Probably totally am.
Let me guess, you want a yellow one?
Yes, and some bird seed, please.
You know, you don't have to buy the parakeet, Curtis.
I know, but you know what they say, when in Rome, do as Romans do. Shit in the Pope's hat, something like that.
Well, here's your medicine.
Thank you, Doc. The FDA would not approve. Screw them. This is a pilgrimage.
What's a pilgrimage?
Precisely. This day in modern medicine has made the pilgrimage an anachronism.
Kind of like a spider or something? A tarantula.
Yeah. No. Yeah. An old one. It's out of fashion. Lost its touch.
How many birds you got now?
Just this one. It's a little something extra for
you. You know, I don't take money for the medication.
Extra for the beautiful
girl. I don't do that.
It's for the beautiful parakeet, Joe. It's my favorite woman.
Bye, Curtis.
Bye, girl.
Bye.
Hungry?
Yeah.
Grandma's cooking dinner. She got some of that chicken casserole you love.
Hey, Jonathan, will you take that stuff inside and then go help Grandma. Grandpa and I are going to talk.
Okay.
Okay?
We'll see you in a minute, buddy.
What's up?
Well, David called.
What did he say?
Not much. I told him you'd had your electricity disconnected.
And?
Well, he asked me if it'd be okay if you moved home.
I am home.
No, I mean with us.
Well, it's a good thing Linda wants that as much as I do.
Sweetheart, I don't think he's coming back. Linda says she's fine to have Jonathan stay with us till things get a little better for you.
I think I can take care of my own son, huh?
I didn't say that. Are you going to have dinner with us or what? Yo, Lynn.
Hey, let me see your hand.
Oh, Lord, go wash those mud mitts right now.
No, not there. I'm preparing food. Go to the bathroom.
And don't touch anything.
Fingernails, too. Mom giving you your eye medicine?
Yeah, twice a day.
Straighten. Go on.
Hey, Grandpa. Will you tell me the story about the sea monster in the lake?
Okay. We are dropping anchor in this green ensign. Now, when I say green, I mean greener than a bullfrog's nipple. Greener than them beans right there. Okay? Has no idea what he's doing. He's letting that chain run out into the ocean, and that chain has links on it that are this big. So before we know it, that guy is ripped clean off the deck, and the only thing sitting there is a severed leg and a trail of blood leading straight overboard.
Whoa.
Have we heard enough?
No, Grandma, this is the best part.
Now, you eat those vegetables, and I'll continue. So now I have to dive in to try to retrieve, right, the body. I mean, for a proper burial, right?
How'd you know he was dead?
Because I had to swim through a cloud of blood and sharks.
Did the sharks eat him?
Probably. I don't know because I never found the body. It was too dangerous, so I just froze and watched. And all of a sudden, up from below came something. I swear I don't know what it was, but it had these big tentacles that came down and wrapped themselves around this full-grown tiger shark like it was a little bitty football.
Was it a giant squid?
Maybe, but it jetted back into the deep blue before I could get a good look at it. I will promise you this, though. There is nothing in the entire ocean that would ever stand a chance against a creature like that.
All right. Are we done? Because I have completely lost my appetite.
Can I be excused?
Can you be excused?
May I be excused?
Fine. Hey, what do you say?
Thank you, Grandma.
You're welcome. I love you.
Love you too. Bye, Grandpa.
Bye, Captain.
Can you please pass the salt? Pretty please. With shark guts on top.
Here, let him get you some medicine, okay? Here, baby. Here. Come lie in Mama's lap. Good night. Chew it up. The pressure's gonna go down.
It hurts real bad tonight.
No, just hang in there, okay? Just keep chewing it.
Hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleep, little baby. And when you wake, you shall have a cake. And all the pretty little horses paint and bay, solemn and gray. All the pretty little horses, so hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleep, little baby. It's kind of hard for me, but I'm a little behind on my rent.
Oh, boy. How far behind?
About 3 months.
3 months? Good Lord, Jolynn. You know I'd love to help you, but I gotta be honest with you. The way they've cut back my retirement, we just flat don't have it, honey.
When David called, did he say he wasn't coming back?
He didn't say anything. I don't know what he's gonna do. That's the truth. Honey, I will do everything I can to help you out. Okay? No promises.
Thanks.
You all set?
Yeah, his headaches have gotten a lot worse. He's been sick to his stomach a lot.
Jonathan. Please. I know the trab was our big hope after the laser surgeries, but often it takes more than one procedure to lower the pressure. With glaucoma, many times surgeries just don't work. Now, you and your husband need to prepare yourselves for the fact that Jonathan may just need to take meds for the rest of his life. So the drops are working to control the pressure spikes.
Yeah, they make his vision blurry, though. He complains about it a lot.
Well, he needs them now. You need to make sure he takes them.
Well, after that allergic reaction, he's afraid of the drops.
I'm gonna keep him on the miotics. The spikes are just too dangerous. I'm going to have to add an oral inhibitor, and we'll see how he does. Contact me immediately if he experiences any shortness of breath. Now, adding these may make him a little tired and weak, just a little sluggish, but that could be good for you. The boys can be a handful.
You ready, Jonathan?
Check the fishing lines at Mr. Upshaw's pond.
Yeah, that's fine. Just don't get caught, okay? No swimming.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I got to go give her a hand in the garden.
Okay.
This is how I maintain my girlish physique.
Hey, Mark.
Yeah.
Thank you for taking us to the doctor today.
Of course.
You know where they came from. Did you talk to Jonathan?
Yeah, he denies it. Seems a little dodgy to me, though.
You should just keep an eye on that boy. Teach him some respect for property.
Don't start.
What are they doing out?
I don't want you going to Grandma's again, okay? Not without me.
Why?
Because I said so. Look, she's pissed because you keep breaking all her stuff.
I didn't mean to.
I know. Anyway, it's just shit anyway. The whole house is full of shit. I'm not going there anymore. Look, I'm gonna take care of you from now on, okay? Till Daddy comes back.
Okay.
Come on. From now on, nobody can come in the house, okay? Nobody. Especially Grandma and Grandpa. You hear me? Oh, it just got shut off.
Well, ain't that shitty. Hey, Jonathan, looking like a stud.
Hey, Natalie.
Hey, I want to tell you something.
Hey, 20 more minutes to PE while we visit. Mm-hmm.
Weebly, help!
Oh, we'll never get out anymore.
I know.
But I can't just leave Jonathan here by himself.
He can take care of himself. I mean, really, what's the worst that can happen? He'd get in your house, it wouldn't be the first time.
All right. Hey, if me and Aunt Natalie went out tonight, would you be good?
Yes, ma'am.
And I don't want you to let Wee Wee in the house, and I don't want you going down to Grandpa's.
Okay.
All right, I'll pick you up at 8.
Bye, sweetie. Bye. Where are y'all going?
Get rent money?
$549.
Hey, are you sure he's got this?
Relax, we can't lose. He's like a computer genius. We need 6 computers split 2 ways.
It's $90. It'll be $45 apiece.
That's all the money I got.
Okay, stop bitching. Pretty soon we're going to be splitting jackpot.
First number out, number 10. Wild number, it's going to be a 9.
Oh, there he is.
Beginning at 9, through 69.
Hey, cowboy.
Hey, ladies.
This is Jolynn.
Looking good. Nice to meet you, Jolynn.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Oh, what we got here? Yeah, Bingo Bill gave me lucky number 6 for me. That's my hot box.
Are y'all feeling the fortune tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Me too. Now, let me go do what it is I do.
I told you he was cute as hell.
Here you go. Don't tell my mom, drink.
You really think I can rig a damn bingo game and be that damn stupid?
This is some shit, man.
Look, I got lucky. Sorry you didn't.
Some bitch. Natalie.
Yeah.
Okay, go.
You trashy ass.
Yeah.
Hey, hey.
Don't kill
me.
One horse sticking up for another?
That's my sister.
Ooh, must run the family.
You don't know shit about my family.
Oh, I don't? What's that, huh? Bet your husband has no idea you're out here horning up at a bingo parlor for a dollar.
Wait.
Yeah, give me a call sometime. We can do that.
Your sister's got my number?
You're out.
I got it.
Sorry about that, y'all. Bitch.
All right, it's cool.
So, how's David?
I don't know. You tell me. I haven't heard from him in over a month.
I haven't either. Mark offered for us to move in with him and Linda.
Why don't you?
What do you think?
Till David comes back.
Oh, please.
Hey, at least the man's trying to do something with his life. It's about time.
Yeah, it must be nice.
At least you got one that's trying to make something of himself for you. Must be nice.
David asked you to call and check on me, didn't he?
He leaves me for 2 months with nothing but a letter, but he calls you.
You don't got no phone.
Yeah, well, I'm not the one that racked up a $500 phone bill booking a tour all over Kingdom Come, either.
I'm just trying to help. Chill.
Help? You just helped me lose everything I had.
You really think I wanted to drag your lame ass out of the house?
Then why did you? You know, you never come over unless you want something.
Maybe I just didn't want to see you end up like Mom.
You really think I'm gonna drink myself to death because a man left me?
I don't know what you do. You've always been the depressed, serious type. Maybe if you relax for once, you can find someone better.
More coffee?
Yeah, fill her up. She likes it black. Get a new wig, bitch.
Kiss my ass! Stupid thing.
So sorry. I will talk to Jonathan in the morning.
No. No. This time you're gonna do something.
What do you want me to do?
Let her run all over you, and now our boy too.
Why don't you do something? Now your family too.
All right, I will. Look, I will take care of this.
I come in?
Sorry, Mama. I don't know why I did it.
You did it because you're a kid. And I keep asking you to be a man for me, but you just need to be a kid.
I missed it. You'll never leave me, will you?
I will never leave you. I love you. I will always, always love you. No matter what. No matter what you become, and no matter if you grow up. You're back.
I'm sorry, Julian.
How come with all the deputies you got, you come see me personally?
Could you step outside, please?
I'm fine right here, thank you.
Well, I need to know where your pig is.
How come you asking?
Well, your neighbor down the hill here, they pressed charges this morning.
My neighbors, that's my husband's parents.
Yeah, I understand that, Joanne, but I have to issue you a citation. Trespassing and vandalism perpetrated by your pet pig. I know. Come on. I'm also going to need to know the whereabouts of your pig. Currently.
You're looking at her.
What are you doing?
God dang.
That's not funny, Joanne. I'm going to tell you something right now, and I mean it, too. You contain your pig, all right? If I catch him off the premises one more time, I'm going to confiscate and euthanize the damn thing. That's bullshit. Ham and eggs, bastard. Pig shit everywhere. Get away from me. Damn hog looking son of a bitch. Yeah.
Well, Linda, they gave me a $250 ticket. You happy?
I didn't want for you to get a ticket.
Well, then why did you call the cops on me?
I wanted to make a statement.
Well, I'm here now. Make your damn statement. Say what you want to say to me.
Okay.
Say it!
You need to get your kid under control. And maybe you should teach him not to steal while you're homeschooling him sub-kindergarten skills.
Kind of like you did your son? The one that walked out on his family? At least I teach my son to be a human fucking being.
That's enough. Outside.
What, you gonna run me out like a little dog now?
Get outside. Now,
Damn it!
Would you please calm down?
You know, she doesn't like the fact that I'm a high school dropout and I'm homeschooling my son, but yet he can't see the damn chalkboard.
I need to tell you something.
No! You know what? She's refusing to accept that he's going blind, even though she's constantly complaining that he's breaking her little shit.
Shush! Let me talk! Okay, Wee-Wee didn't just get into her garden last night. Jonathan led her there. Tore the whole thing to pieces.
You saw him?
Yeah, fired a shot up into the air to run him off. You have got to get this situation under control. Okay, if you can't afford to pay rent or utilities, you damn sure can't afford to feed a 300-pound nuisance.
David gave him that pig. He loves her.
A full-grown pig is not a pet.
You want to tell your grandson that?
No, I'm not trying to tell you what to do. I'm just saying that with your circumstance, you have got to explore some options.
I gotta go. I'm sorry.
It's Jolynn.
Hey, buddy.
Hi. Hey, Curtis.
I was just riffing. Yeah. I got cooler songs. I was just, you know, riffing around.
Yeah, do you mind if we come in for a minute?
Oh, please, come on in. Come on in.
You got a fish tank?
Yeah, salt water.
Where's all the fish?
It's just one. I used to call him Neptune. Now we'll call him Ineptune.
What kind of fish is he?
He's an octo-wuss. Might as well be a chocolate starfish. He's a shit fish. You never see him. He just hides all day. But that is Plissken. He's a total badass. Always trying to escape and shit. But breaking out is impossible. Breaking in is insane. That? It's Peter North Parker, you know, because he's a spider. Man, he's just so big and all. And this is Klaus Meine. Let me show you something. Check this out. That is love at first sting right there. You! Jonathan!
He's obsessed with the ocean. If he had a shark in there, he would never leave.
Hey, Jonathan. You like music? You like music?
Mm-hmm.
Check this out. Some dude in Austin gave this to me for a bag of weed killer. Said it was an import. You like this?
I don't like it. I love it.
Who's yours? Take
it. Can I listen to it back?
Of course. All you want.
Stuff,
is
it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, John, make yourself at home. All of it.
All of it.
Shit. I only have a week's worth left.
Oh, I got a couple days worth.
What about his regular meds?
I told you about the complications he has. He just responds better to the hydro than he does his pharmaceutical crap.
The only guy I know is Lonnie, and he only sells a quarter pound.
I can't afford that much.
We go at half?
I can't afford that either.
Well, maybe I could sell some shit. Ratshaw owes me some. It's too bad we live in Texas. If we were on the coast, Hydro would be doctor's orders.
Man, you ever think about leaving Texas?
I don't know, man. I like it here. In Texas, you may have shit, but you will always have your dignity. Here, you can throw your head in a toilet bowl and lick it clean. That'll at least make you the baddest son of a bitch in the room.
How do you figure that?
One word. The Alamo. Which reminds me, you want to see my dad's most prized possession?
I don't know. What is it?
I'll be right back. Listen to Ozzy Osbourne because he pissed on the Alamo. You'd think Ozzy pissed on his mother's grave. He's so serious about it. Check this out.
What is it?
That is an actual musket ball from the Alamo.
Seriously?
Hell no. That's an old fishing weight I hammered down. I told him it was pride from Colonel Travis's bedroom. He's so damn proud of that thing, you'd think it was Bowie's own blade. I just don't have the balls to break his heart, tell him the truth now.
It's really awful, Curtis.
Yeah, the old bastard's happy. That's all that matters.
I wonder how many times I've been lied to by a man just to make me happy.
Well, he'd be a fool. Shit. I'm sorry.
No, it's, it's fine. No, it's fine. I mean, I should probably go check on Jonathan anyway, huh?
Hey, Jonathan!
What?
What are you doing?
Looking for Neptune, but I can't find him.
I'm telling you, he's a shy pet. You'll never find that lazy water bastard.
Jonathan, let's go.
Guess what I did today? It was a baby, but it's the real thing. The mom's still out there. Sorry you couldn't be there, but Grandpa says 100 takes a shot once he has it. We had to celebrate with jelly beans.
Jelly beans.
What?
Not in like the strawberries.
Thank you. Hey.
What?
What are you doing?
Looking for something to eat.
Well, go play. I want my son to eat. Please, if you gotta go, go out back like Dad. You gotta go number two, then just go behind the shed. Look, I'm serious, okay? Go play and I'll make us some oatmeal. Go on.
Sugar in it?
We're out of sugar, thank you very much. You got any jelly beans left?
Yeah.
Let me put those in there.
Gross. Why can't we go to Grandpa's?
Because I told you not to.
I don't want my mom.
We finish your skills, okay? All right, do you mind her?
Hi. She made me pull over to look at the parakeets.
No, it's fine. They make great pets.
No, she won't be getting one. I would have to take care of it.
Oh. Hey, Julie.
No, I couldn't open the attachment.
They're pretty. I want one.
No, you don't take care of your puppy or the turtle.
The puppy is ugly and poops on the floor. Turtles are stupid. I want a parakeet.
Well, which one do you like, sweetie?
No, Kimmy, let's go.
I want a blue one.
I got yellow ones.
I don't want a stupid yellow one. I want a blue one.
Hold on 1 second. Kimmy's about to throw a hurricane.
Stupid.
I don't have any blue ones here, but I just live right up the street. We could go get a couple there.
She has a blue one at home.
You know, pick one of these if you want one and let's go.
Why do you guys do this?
I have nystagmus and glaucoma.
Ew.
Want some jelly beans?
Sure. Hey, Mama, you want a jelly bean?
No, thank you.
Hey, why'd you take my jelly beans? Okay.
Cam?
You'll have to excuse the place. It's a bit of a disaster since my husband's been on tour.
Oh, really? My little brother is in Afghanistan.
Oh, no, my husband's a musician.
Oh, cool. I'm sorry, you'll have to excuse me. I have to take this. Hey, Julie.
Hey.
No, I haven't.
Now, hey, shut up. You never fully plan your mind.
This is Captain Jonathan at First Mate Camp, looking for any sea monsters in the area.
I don't want to be a first mate. I want to be a mermaid.
Why mermaids? Mermaids are boring. They don't fight.
I don't care. I want to be a mermaid.
Then get in. If you want to be a mermaid, you have to get in the ocean.
I'm not getting in there.
Watch out!
Why?
Sea snake! Man the harpoons!
It's just an old spray.
No, it's a sea serpent.
Don't be stupid.
Pretty blue bird.
Oh, no. Mom, get it away from me. Get it away from me.
We have to go. Hold your hand. Be careful. Watch your step. Get in the car. We gotta go.
Okay.
We'll get our own ride back.
Are you sure?
Yeah, that's fine. We'll walk or something.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Hey, Grandma.
Well, hey there, little rascal. Where you been? You want to help me fix my garden?
No.
Why not?
Because Mom said that I couldn't come in your house or your yard.
Why'd she say that?
I don't know, but can I have a drink from the hose?
Of course.
But don't tell Mom.
Why?
Because our water got turned off today.
Well, sure, of course. Okay.
Hello, Joe. Here I am. Better late than never, I guess. I hope. I started to write you 1,000 times, but the words just never seemed to fit. This morning, I woke up in a motel room in Memphis to the sight of one regal little cockroach perched on my pillow. Just staring at me. Before I knew it, all I could think about was Galveston. That night we spent together. That morning we woke to find an entire army of cockroaches closing in on last night's dinner. Our very first taste of freedom. Everything was so simple then. So clear. The one time I knew exactly what I wanted. I just wanted you. I miss you, Joe. I do. I know this has been hard on you, but things really seem to be picking up out here. The shows are getting better, and I finally have a little money to send your way. I wish I was sending more. How's Wee Wee and the Wonder Boy? I hope he understands. I used to see the world like he does. Now there's a question for everything. I can't seem to hold on to anything. I wish I could just go back to that motel in Galveston. It made sense. I don't know why I can't. Maybe I'm broken. Maybe I can fix it. But for now, I'll just keep searching. Searching for you.
That's it?
I got this too.
Dang.
I know.
Not bad.
I know.
Man, it won't scan.
Something wrong with it?
I don't know. It says you won $200. Hey, Leon, you take a look at this?
Darn it. I told you to move that bucket.
We all going to be millionaires? I don't know. I think the scanner's busted.
Gambling, huh? No, this is Tennessee Lotto.
Oh.
So you guys can't cash this here?
Sorry, Jolene. It's only good in Tennessee.
Come on, Jonathan.
I drive to Tennessee for $200.
Jonathan? Please come take your medicine and brush your teeth.
Okay, guess what?
What?
I have this dream that a lobster doesn't have a brain.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Its skin is in its forehead, and its teeth are in its stomach.
Please chew with your mouth closed.
So if you're ever facing a giant lobster, I'll bash it in its forehead to kill it.
I am a lucky, lucky woman. Okay, go to bed, please.
Oh! Please forgive me for being a bad mother. I know I ain't gonna give my child what he needs. I promise you I'll be better. I can't do this on my own.
Are you Jonathan?
Yeah, who are you?
I'm Gail. Can I talk to you? I just want to ask you a few questions. I'm friends with your grandma.
Okay.
So where's your mama?
Asleep.
Have you had breakfast?
No, but she'll probably make oatmeal when she gets up.
You don't like oatmeal, do you?
No.
I heard that you have a pet pig.
Yeah, Wee Wee.
And I heard that Wee Wee sleeps in your bedroom.
Sometimes, but Mama don't like her in the house.
She doesn't? Hmm. Well, can I see your bedroom?
Okay.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Gail with Social Services.
Step away from her, Jonathan.
I'd advise you to put down the gun, ma'am.
What are you doing in my house?
I'm just doing my job. Now, there's no reason to be upset.
Do you have a warrant?
No, not yet.
Then get the hell out of my house!
I advise that you comply with our investigation.
Well, I'd advise you to stay the hell off my property.
Okay. But if you don't cooperate, I come back with a court order and an officer to escort me. Let's talk about this.
You stay the hell away from my son. I don't want you to ever talk to that woman again. Ever.
Boy's dad was away. The mama Leviathan sent sea monsters to attack his home. The crab monster came first. Then came the big fat one with 1,000 eyes. No matter how many sea monsters the mama Leviathan sent, he will always protect his mother.
Yes? I'm looking for Mark.
He's out back working.
Hey, stranger.
Hi.
Something wrong?
Why'd you call CPS on me?
What are you talking about?
I'd expect that from her, but not from you.
Oh, boy. Yeah, we had a fight about it.
Yeah, well, they came to the house.
No, I'm sorry, Jolynn. This is not my doing. This is her thing. I happen to think you're a pretty good mother. She's just trying to do what she thinks is right. Now, I'm in no position to judge anybody, but the way you and David live, that is not the way we raised him. Let me show you something. You see those medals right there? Well, those are my most cherished personal possessions, and here they sit in this dirty garage because they don't go well with her knickknacks. Sometimes in life, you got to choose your battles. Now, her little ceramic trinkets may mean more to her than those do, but those do not mean more to me than she does.
I'm sorry, that's the most pathetic thing I've ever heard. Come
on. Don't make fun of me.
She's luckier than hell to have you.
Yeah, she is.
You ever think you could love somebody else?
Now, why would you ask me that?
I mean, do you feel like you love her because she's the one? Or did you decide long before she threw you out in the shed?
Frankly, I don't see what the hell difference it makes anyway, because it's not like I'm going anywhere. Sweetie, sometimes in life you get to choose your family. And sometimes you don't. But that doesn't make them any less family. I mean, like you, to me, you are my daughter. You always have been, you always will be. And that's just the way that is. Because I love you. No matter what you may decide to do.
I owe you more than I ever could pay.
No, you don't owe me anything.
For once, I'm offering you something.
I'm listening.
Your freezer full of meat. You meet me back at the generator at 9 o'clock? And don't tell John.
I'll be there.
You want to go on a trip with me?
Where will we go?
Wherever we want.
Can we go to the ocean?
Yeah, we could try.
When will we go?
Tomorrow. But you gotta promise me something.
What?
Can't tell anybody. Okay?
Okay.
Promise?
I promise.
Okay. It's just gonna be me and you.
What about Whaley?
I'm gonna have to ask Grandpa to take care of her.
Okay.
Okay, go on.
Once there's a little boy, and him and his mom and his pig went out to the ocean. And he's trying to protect his mom from the Leviathan because he killed her little baby. The Leviathan's baby. Sharky piggy 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 piggy. And the Leviathan is a giant old octopus that can stand on land. Real sea monster. So the little boy and Wee Wee, the shark piggy, went to go fight this Leviathan. Wee Wee, no! After 5 miles of swimming, digestive systems growl for hunger and food, this long arm came up and swept up Wee Wee. Luckily, it didn't eat her before I could save her. He said it was worth it for saving his mom and his pig.
Jonathan! What happened? You knocked yourself out! Why did you jump out of the boat?
I don't know. My eyes hurt.
Not now.
Okay.
Curtis?
Hey, what's up? You okay?
Look, can we come in? We need your help.
Oh, shit. Yeah. You sure you want to make a 9-year-old take vapors?
If we don't relieve the pressure, the damage is permanent, so I'm not gonna let him go blind. All right, listen. I want you to open your mouth, and I'm gonna blow air into your mouth, okay?
Okay.
It might make you cough a little bit, but I want you to hold it in as long as you can. Okay. Can you do that for me? I know it tastes funny, but that's just because it's a mess, okay? That's a really good job. Now we're gonna do it one more time for me, okay?
Hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleep, little baby. And when you wake, you shall have a cake and all the pretty little horses, paints and bays, sorrel and grace, all the pretty little horses. So hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleep, little baby.
So that phone's gotta be worth at least a couple $100. And then the scratch-offs get his cash.
Where'd you get this phone at?
Don't matter. I need this for him.
Okay. I'll do it. For you.
For Jonathan.
For Jonathan. Nice phone.
Yeah.
Hey, Lonnie. Hey, man. Hey, it's Curtis. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, could you maybe come by my place and bring that real cute Cupid doll that I like so much? No, the Cupid doll, the real nice one. Buddy, I need a quarter pound of hydro. The best you got. All right. All right. All right. Thanks. Bye, buddy. You can call back in 10. If we got to go somewhere, you're driving.
I can't, Curtis. Jonathan's inside. I'm not leaving him.
He's passed out cold. If he wakes up, he'll be fine by himself.
No, man, if something happens, I'll lose him.
Okay, if something happens... I got 2 DWIs already. If I get caught driving again, No way. No way. I am way too pretty for prison.
No, I'm not driving, Curtis. I can't.
At least you get to drive a balls-to-the-wall classic. This is a 300 F&Z, baby. 170 horsepower rear-wheel drive, V6. Man, this car cost $30,000 when it was brand new.
Yeah, in like 1982?
1986, man.
Yeah, well, what's it worth now?
Who cares? It's got T-tops. Man, they don't even make those anymore. And that rear window is louvered. That is some posh shit. It's like having French blinds on your car. There he is. I'll be right back. How you doing, Lonnie?
Shit, man, I've had better days. Hey, man, push me on this thing, will you?
What?
I used to love this thing when I was a kid. Push me.
Okay.
Hey, not so fast. Hey, do I look like a screaming schoolgirl? Ah! Hop on. How long has it been since you've been on one of these?
Been a while. I hate these damn things. I'm sorry, Lonnie. I can't stand playing in the park all day. Seriously, I think I'm gonna vomit. Can we just do this? It's all there.
Point in a man's life when he aims to enjoy a place like this.
Is everything all right?
See you around. Sorry, Curtis. Sometimes you gotta throw the dog a bone or else he'll come after yours. She good, but now you've got the dust. And if the Lord's forsaken us, he ever was, I'll never know. If we do cry Jezebel, we were lucky kids to miss the flight. Cause there's a boy with a coin by the wishing well. Yes, wishing well. Yes, I will leave my ball and chain with tender love forevermore. weightless. There's no hurdle standing in my path. There's no baseball bats or toys, I guess. I will carry on this weightless. I will carry on this weightless. I will carry on this weightless. I will carry on this weightless.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. This is all my fault.
Don't say anything. I don't know if they're listening. But if you bastards are, I want you to know what you don't find was never there. I got to go now. I'm not taking traces, but look. Don't worry about me. I called to say that you and your special someone are safe. I would never do anything to hurt you.
Thank you so much, Curtis. I can never repay you.
No. I got to go. Bye, girl.
See him.
But I don't want girls to see me.
So their mamas can see them. Close your eyes.
Mark, you can't do this. Will you put that away?
Get on in there.
Attica. I'm sorry, girl.
Do it, Jolynn.
None of your business. Come on.
Don't do that to my arm. It hurts. I'm sorry.
Grandpa had to take Wee Wee, so let's go inside. Push harder. That's just like a tip. Oh, yeah, that feels good. Oh, yeah, that's the stuff. You got cute little feet.
Thank you.
They're stinky, but they're cute. Try to be a good way to catch you.
Yeah, monsters. This little piggy monster was a stinky fish monkey. This little piggy monster said no. This little piggy had some ham. This little piggy had none. This little piggy went wee, 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 all the way home. What'd I say, Mama? What's wrong? Mama, what's wrong? Everything's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be okay, Mama. Everything's gonna be all right. Promise.
You promise.
I promise. You okay?
Come here, baby. Lie down, my mama.
So pale, and you turn so white. It looked so fragile in the hallway light. And everyone was wondering if you were made of porcelain. And everyone was wondering closer. If you were made of porcelain, if you were made of porcelain.
Morning, Captain.
Morning.
You hungry?
Mm-hmm.
Should we say a prayer?
God's great, God's good, same for food, just name Amen.
Amen. Eat all your medicine. It's good? Ready?
Yes. Can I ask you a question?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we just let the parakeets go?
So bad if we do that. It's better this way.
Found the bottom. And it's in the same place it's always been. I'm sorry I put you through this. I thought this was what I wanted. But I want my family. I need my family. I'm coming home. And if you let me, I'll make this up to you and Jonathan, I promise. If you get this before I do, I should be just around the corner. So we'll see who gets there faster. Me or my words. I love you. David.
Hey, if I gave you a dollar, would you put a stamp and throw that in the mail for me?
I got it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Jonathan, you ready? What tickets are available that'll get us to the beach?
One way, a round trip.
One way, please.
Okay.
Well, Miami, for an adult and a child, would be $367.50. And for San Diego, it would be $409.50.
Okay. You got anything cheaper?
It's Galveston.
How much?
Galveston would be $90.25.
Perfect.
You know, I'm going to help you. I got the quarter.
There's a little boy, and he got a little piglet once he was only 5 years old.
One, two, three.
Once he was 9 or so, him and his mom and his pig went out to the ocean, because he loves the sea. And him and Sharky Piggy went to go find the little boy's dad. He was lost in the ocean. But instead, they ran into the Mama Leviathan. In anger, the Leviathan tried to kill us. And he had to fight to the death. I kept on stabbing him. Stabbing him. Stabbing him. Stupid octopus.
They lived happily ever after with eating octopus every day.
I always knew you'd leave before our time was done and sail far away on a boat you built for one. Farewell, sailor boy. I will no longer assume that you take me with you on your boat that has no room. Don't be too sure you'll find something better, something more. And the girl you left behind, crying on the shore. The storm is now upon you, and your oars begin to bend. Your pride has busted through. You're at the mercy of the